While appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Legal Affairs to submit on the Law Revision Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2022, which is under consideration by the committee, the Directorate of Public Prosecution rejected the proposed amendments in Section 154 of the Penal Code Act, Cap 120, to include married men in the offence of adultery. Jonathan Mwaganya, a senior state attorney from the office of the DPP, submitted that instead of including men on adultery offences, the entire section should be repealed because there are practical challenges in both prosecution and enforcement of this offence.
We may end up re-legislating a provision that will remain redundant and with very serious practical enforcement challenges. So we propose for a total repeal of section 154.
The offence of adultery was outlawed by the Constitutional Court in the petition of 2005 between Law and Advocacy for Women in Uganda versus Attorney General on grounds that it was discriminating against married women because it was providing for adultery against women alone. But the DPP says there is no need of legislating on morality.
Thank you for that, because we actually looked at it and we said sometimes we legislate things which should not be offences. Even some of these sexual cases, when you look at them, you're torn apart. You say, is this, because how can a father defy their own daughter? Are they okay? Should we criminalize it? Or should it be a social problem and we handle it as that? You see, some of the questions that come up and we say, at the end of the day, should we legislate on everything? So this was one of them, and we say, no, this is just totally, it's just a social problem.
Members of the committee welcome total repeal of the adultery offence, saying it is no longer an offence in modern society.
It's only very primitive societies that outlaw consensual sex. And we were stuck in that primitive position. Honorable Chair, I told you in the morning that my wife has a right to have consensual sex with any man of her choice. Like, I also retained that right.
Officials of the Directorate of Public Prosecution, led by the DPP, Jane Francis Apodo, asked the committee to also repeal other penal laws which were recently declared unconstitutional. These include the Law on Vagabonds, Section 25 of the Computer Misuse Act, Section 8 of the Public Order Management Act, and Sections 2, 11, 13, and 15 of the Anti-Pornography Act.
It is a case of Andrew Karamaji and another versus Attorney General. In that case, the Constitutional Court also recently declared Section 25 of the Computer Misuse Act unconstitutional. That we don't see it being captured in this bill.
The DPP, Apodo, has also spoken out on the delayed trial of the two MPs, Mohammed Segunya and Alan Sewanyana. She blamed the judiciary for the delay to fix the trial, saying investigations were concluded a long time ago.
Which is ongoing for honorable members of parliament who are in jail. Yesterday I visited Chitalia. So, and it was stated that the prison officers are bashing the orders of the court. Four of them, those people are mandated for special treatment. And they are saying you are still investigating for their cases. And they are there, need special attention as regards to medication.
We already committed them. When we commit them to the High Court for trial, which means investigations are done, we're just waiting for, we are ready, for us we are ready. We are ready to hear their case, to present the case. It is just that there are so many gymnastics played in courts, and we have no control over that. If the lawyers for the defense want to take a case for constitutional interpretation, our answer type.
But story by Fred Kajibi for the news.